Hello friends, today I am again back with part 2 lecture of stereochemistry of alkane and cycloalkane and their conformation. In the part 1 video lecture, I discussed the conformation of alkanes. So just a recap of what we learned in the first class. The conformers are the different stereoisomers or the different geometrical arrangement of atoms or group within a molecule due to rotation along a carbon-carbon sigma bond. Then there are two types of conformer. One is the eclipse form, the other one is the staggered form. Eclipse conformer is unstable compared to the staggered conformer because in eclipse conformer we are having the torsional strain. The staggered conformer is slightly more stable than the eclipse conformer because in the staggered conformer there is no torsional strain. So in addition to, there may be a van der Waals strain. So in today's lecture, I will be discussing conformation of cyclohexane. Now cyclohexane, they are analogs of alkane. They have a ring structure. We also call them as the acyclic hydrocarbons. So today's my presentation for you. This is the presentation for you. This is the presentation for you. Conformation of alkane and cycloalkane, part 2. Now, what are cycloalkanes? The cycloalkanes are cyclic hydrocarbons. They have got the general formula CnH2n, where n may be 3, 4, 5, 6, etc. So cycloalkanes, they contain a ring of carbon atoms, and each carbon atom is attached to two methyl groups. So we can call them as a ring compounds, where the ring contains methylene groups. They have general formula CnH2n. They are nonpolar, insoluble in water, like your alkanes. They have compact shape, and their melting and boiling point is similar to brass alkane with same number of carbon atoms. So the melting and boiling point of alkane and cycloalkane having same number of carbon atom is more or less same, but their chemical properties are different. So as you know, alkane, the name stands for the paraffin, which means low reactivity. Alkanes have low reactivity, and we studied the low reactivity of alkane is due to the similar in electronegativity of carbon and hydrogen. So carbon-hydrogen bonds are nonpolar bond, so neither electrophile nor electrophile can attack this bond. But unlike alkane, cycloalkanes, propane, butane, they are much, much more reactive than their open chain analog. For example, propane, it will not react with hydroiodic acid, but cyclopropane, if you treat it with hydroiodic acid, immediately you will get iodopropane. Now, the low reactivity of alkane, we could explain that it is due to the similar electronegativity of carbon and hydrogen. But why cyclopropane is more reactive than alkane? Why cyclobutane is more reactive than butane? So these questions were answered by Adolf von Baeyer in the 19th century, and he proposed a theory which is called the Baeyer strain theory. And Baeyer, he assume that cycloalkane has got planar ring structure. That means all the carbon atoms in the ring are in the same plane. So assume cycloalkanes are planar polygons, planar, that means all the carbon atoms lie in the same plane. And as a result, what happens? There is a deviation from the normal tetrahedral bonding. And as a result, due to deviation from the normal tetrahedral bond angle of 109 degree 28 minute or 109.5 degree, it gives rise to an angle strain. And it is due to angle strain, cyclopropane is unstable than corresponding propane. So Bayer deserves credit for advancing the idea of angle strain as a destabilizing factor. So in previous classes, when we dealt with alkenes, we found there are two types of strain. One is the torsional strain and there is a van der Waals strain. And in order to explain the conformer and the stability of cycloalkane, Bayer injected a new idea, which is called the angle strain. And this angle strain arises due to deviation from the normal bond angle of 109 degree 28 minute of a tetrahedral carbon or a sp3 hybridized carbon. So types of strain: torsional strain, it is due to eclipse bond, which you have seen in the eclipse ethene. Then there is a van der Waals strain, which you have seen in the totally eclipse conformer of butane and the Gotch form of butane. Then the another strain, which was pointed out by Adolf Bayer, and that is called the angle strain. And that angle strain results from distortion or deviation of bond angle from normal value. So the normal tetrahedral bond angle is 109 degree 28 minute. So if you want to deviate it from 109 degree 28 minute, then there will be a strain in the molecule. And this strain is termed as angle strain. So how do we measure this strain in cycloalkane? So you know that you can measure the stability in terms of heat of combustion. You can measure stability in terms of heat of hydrogenation. But cycloalkanes are saturated molecules, so we cannot hydrogenate them and calculate the heat of hydrogenation. But what we can do, we can carry its combustion. And then we can measure the heat of combustion. And from heat of combustion, we can find out the stability of cycloalkanes. Now, heat of combustion can be used to compare the stability of isomers. So higher heat of combustion, it is less stable. So when the heat of combustion is higher, then the stability is low, and that particular isomer will be less stable. And when heat of combustion is low, then the stability will be high. So stability is inversely proportional to heat of combustion. But cyclopropane, cyclobutane are not isomer. Cyclopropane has got only three carbon atoms. There are three CH2 group. Cyclobutane has got four CH2 group. Cyclopentane has got five CH2 group. Cyclohexane has got six CH2 group. So as the number of carbon atom increases, then heat of combustion will increase. So all heat of combustion increases as the number of carbon atom increases. But what we can do, we can divide it, the heat of combustion, by the number of CH2 group. For example, in cyclopropane, there are three CH2 group. So what I can do, if I divide the heat of combustion of cyclopropane by factor 3, then I will get heat of combustion per CH2 group, per methyl group. Then again, in cyclobutane, there are four CH2 group. So definitely the heat of combustion of cyclobutane will be higher than cyclopropane. But if I divide the heat of combustion of cyclobutane by 4, then I will get heat of combustion per CH2 group. Similarly, if we divide the heat of combustion of cyclopentane by 5, because there are five CH2 group, then I will get heat of combustion per CH2 group. So we can compare the stability of cycloalkanes by comparing the heat of combustion per CH2 group. So here there, this is cyclopropane. Its heat of combustion is 2091 kilojoule per mole. And if you divide it by 3, because in cyclopropane there are 3 carbon atoms, then the value comes 697. That means per methylene group, per CH2 group, the heat of combustion in cyclopropane is 697. Then cyclobutane, definitely it has got 4 carbon atoms, so its heat of combustion is higher than cyclopropane. its heat of combustion is 2,721 kilojoule per mole. And if you divide it by 4, then the value is 681 kilojoule per mole. Cyclobutane, cyclopentane, the heat of combustion is 3,291 kilojoule per mole. And per CH2 group, which is obtained by dividing this value by 5, it is 658 kilojoule per mole. So here you can see the heat of combustion per CH2 group for cyclopropane, cyclobutane, cyclopentane, cyclohexane, cycloheptane, and so on. So highest heat of combustion per CH2 group is for cyclopropane. It is 697 kilojoule per mole. Then for cyclobutane, it is 681 kilojoule per mole, which means cyclobutane is slightly less stable than, slightly more stable than cyclopropane. Similarly, the heat of combustion for cyclopentane is 658 kilojoule per mole, which means that the cyclopentane is more stable than cyclobutane. And out of all of them, you see the heat of combustion for cyclohexane per methyl group is least. It is only 653 kilojoule per mole. So out of different cycloalkanes, cyclopropane, cyclobutane, cyclopentane, cyclohexane, cycloheptane, cyclohexane is most stable. So again, I am repeating that you can measure stability in terms of heat of combustion. High heat of combustion, less stability. But cyclopropane, cyclobutane, they are not isomer. As the number of carbon atom increases, heat of combustion will also increase. So the best way is to compare the heat of combustion per methylene group. And the heat of combustion per methylene group can be obtained by dividing the heat of combustion per mole divided by the total number of carbon atoms in the ring. So these are the values of cyclo heat of combustion per CH2 group for cyclopropane, cyclobutane, cyclopentane, etc. So from this chart, you can see clearly that the heat of combustion per CH2 group for cyclopropane is highest, and it is 697 kilojoule per mole. For cyclobutane, it is 681, and out of the different cycloalkanes, the heat of combustion per CH2 group is least for cyclohexane. That means cyclohexane is most stable among the cycloalkanes. So these are the same thing. Here the values are given in terms of kilocalorie per mole. So ring size, there are 3 carbon atoms. Ring size 4 means there are 4 carbon atoms. So to find out the heat of combustion per CH2 group, you have to divide the molar heat of combustion by the ring size. So we'll get this value. So cyclopropane is less stable per methylene group than any other. So the heat of combustion per methyl group for cyclopropane, methylene group for cyclopropane, that is the heat of combustion per CH2 group for cyclopropane is highest. That means cyclopropane is thermodynamically most unstable. Now, why it is unstable? So Bayer explained that in cyclopropane, there is a deviation, there is a distortion from the normal bond angle. So as you know, that the normal tetrahedral bond angle is 109.5 degree. That means when carbon atom is sp3 hybridized, the bond angle should be 109.5 degree. But in cyclopropane, this is cyclopropane, all the 3 carbon atoms, they are occupying the 3 corners of an equilateral triangle. So the normal bond angle for this carbon atom should have been 109.5 degree because this carbon atom is sp3 hybridized. But in cyclopropane, the carbon atoms occupy the 3 corners of an equilateral triangle. So the bond angle is 60 degree. And so there is a deviation of 49.5 degree from normal tetrahedral bond angle. So you can imagine that a spring is being compressed. So this is an open spring with an angle of 109.5 degree. And during the formation of cyclopropane, this spring is compressed, and compression always lead to this stability. So they are going to explain the instability or instability of cyclopropane in terms of angle strain. And the angle strain is measured to be 49.5 degree per CH2 group or per carbon atom. And it is due to collapsing of the normal tetrahedral bond angle from 109 degree, 9.5 degree to 60 degree in cyclopropane. And moreover, if you look at the stick and ball model, you can see that the bonds are eclipsed, and due to eclipse, there is also a torsional strain. So there are two factors leading to instability. One is the angle strain, the other one is a torsional strain. So this is cyclopropane with the ball and stick model. The bond angle is 60 degree. The normal bond angle should have been 109 degree 28 minute. And due to compressing of the bond, there is a distortion of 49 degree 28 minute in cyclopropane. And moreover, in cyclopropane, the bonds are eclipsed. So in addition to angle strain, there is a torsional strain. So it leads to instability. I hope it is understood by all. Now, what about cyclobutane? So what is the bond angle in cyclobutane? The bond angle in cyclobutane is 90 degree. The bond angle in cyclopropane was 60 degree. So there is a less angle strain in cyclobutane. So this is cyclobutane. All the four carbon atoms are at the four corners of a square. So the bond angle turned to be 90 degree. And the open bond angle for a tetrahedral carbon is 109.5 degree. So due to formation of cyclobutane, there is a distortion of 19.5 degree angle compression. So this is an open spring, and due to formation of cyclobutane, the spring is compressed. And how much you are compressing? By 19.5 degree. And this is angle strain. And due to angle strain, it is unstable. So the angle strain in cyclopropane is more than in cyclobutane. So cyclopropane is less stable than cyclobutane. And moreover, in cyclobutane, bonds are in the eclipse form. Here you can see it in the Newman projection. The bonds are in all the four carbon atoms are in the same plane. So there is hydrogens are eclipsed. So in addition to angle strain, there is slight amount of torsional strain due to eclipse bond. Now, what about cyclohexane? Now, the cyclohexane, it's heat of combustion per CH2 group. It was 653 kilojoule per mole. And moreover, the chemical reactivity of hexane and cyclohexane is almost same. Now, if we consider that cyclohexane to be a planar molecule, so this is a planar molecule for cyclohexane. This is cyclohexane. If we consider it to be a planar molecule, then all the six carbon atoms will be in the same plane. Then this bond angle will be 120 degree. Normal bond angle is 109 degree to 8 minute. So if cyclohexane is planar molecule, then bond angle will be 120 degree, which is again deviating from the normal tetrahedral bond angle of 109 degree to 8 minute. So there will be again an angle strain. And angle strain will lead to this stability. But cyclohexane is found to be a stable molecule. Unlike cyclopropane, cyclobutane, it does not react with hydroiodic acid. And moreover, the heat of combustion per methylene group is least for cyclohexane. Bayer could not explain it. Because Bayer assumed that cycloalkane has got a planar geometry. So this is the failure of Bayer strain theory. So in order to explain the stability of cyclohexane, Morse, he proposed two conformation for cyclohexane. One is the chair form, which is non-planar. So we call it as the Packard conformation, which means it is not planar. Bayer proposed that cycloalkanes are non-Packard, means they are planar molecule. But if you assume cycloalkane to be planar, then there will be definitely high degree of angle strain. So in order to explain the stability of cyclohexane, Morse proposed two conformation for cyclohexane. One is the chair form, the other one is the boat form. So I will speak later on about the boat form. So this is the chair form. You can see this is the chair form. We usually draw it like this. So this is compared to be a chair. So 1, 2, 3, 4 carbon atoms are in the same plane. So these are the four carbon atoms. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. These four carbon atoms are in the same plane. One carbon atom is at the top. The other carbon atom is the bottom. So this conformation can be compared to a chair. So this is a chair. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And if you assume these corners are occupied by carbon atom, you will get this structure. So this is the chair conformation of cyclohexane. There is no angle strain. All bond angles are tetrahedral, 109 degree to 8 minute. And if we look at the Newman projection formula, then you will see that the chair conformation is in the staggered form. So chair conformation of staggered cyclohexane is highly stable because there is no angle strain. All bond angle is 109 degree to 8 minute. And moreover, the chair conformation is in the staggered form. The staggered form can be visualized in the Newman projection. Then what about the other? The other one is the boat form. So this is a boat. Again, four carbon atoms are in the same plane and two carbon atoms are above. So in chair carbon atom, in the chair conformation, four carbon atoms were in the same plane. One carbon atom was at the top and the other carbon atom was at the bottom of the plane. But in the boat conformation, what is happening? All the four carbon atoms are in the same plane and the remaining two carbon atoms are at the top. So it looks like a boat. This is a boat. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 carbon atom. It is a boat. Now the problem is in the boat conformation, there is no angle strain. All bond angle are 109 degree to 8 minute. But if you watch the boat conformation in the Newman projection, this is the Newman projection. You see that it is in the eclipse form. So eclipse form will lead to destability because eclipse form will bring torsional strain. So these are the two extreme cases. One is the chair conformation. There is no angle strain. All the bond angle is 109 degree to 8 minute. There is no torsional strain because all the bonds are staggered. In boat conformation, there is no angle strain, but there is a torsional strain because it is clear from the Newman projection of boat conformation that the bonds are in the eclipse form. And moreover, these two hydrogen, they are very, very close. And these two hydrogen are called flagpole hydrogen. And they are separated by distance less than van der Waals distance between two atoms, between two hydrogen atoms. So because these two hydrogen atoms are very, very close, so there is a van der Waals strain. So van der Waals strain exists between these two flagpole hydrogen, 1, 2. Why? Because these two hydrogen are very, very close. And their distance is less than the normal van der Waals distance between two hydrogen atoms. And as a result, in boat conformation, there is no angle strain, but there is torsional strain due to eclipse conformation. and there is a van der Waals strain due to repulsion between the two flagpole hydrogen. Why these two hydrogen are repelling each other? Because these two hydrogen are separated by distance less than van der Waals distance. Now, if I twist the boat, you hold on these two carbon atom and it twist it, then what happened? The two flagpole hydrogen will move away from each other. This is the twist form. The boat is getting twisted. You hold on the two nose of the boat and it twist it. Then what happened? These two flagpole hydrogen, one, two, they move away from each other. And as a result, what happens? The van der Waals strain get relieved to some extent. So the twist boat is slightly more stable than the boat form. So we have found there are three conformations: the chair form, the boat form, and out of chair and boat, chair is more stable because there is no angle strain, there is no torsional strain, there is no van der Waals strain. But in the boat conformation, there is no angle strain because all bond angle are 109 degree to 8 minute, but there is van der Waals strain due to two flagpole hydrogen, as well as there is a torsional strain because the bonds are in the eclipse conformation. And if you twist the boat, the flagpole hydrogen moves slightly away from each other and the strain slightly relieves. So the twist boat is slightly more stable than the boat form. So another conformation of cyclohexane that is preformed, that is the boat form. This is the boat form which I am talking about. This is a boat. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is 6 carbon atom, and if you join them, it takes the form of a boat. And these two hydrogen, which are named as the flagpole hydrogen, they are separated by only 1.83 angstrom, which is much less than normal van der Waals distance of 2.5 angstrom. So they repel each other, and due to repulsion, there is a van der Waals strain. So the summary is, boat form is slightly unstable than the chair form, because unlike chair form, boat form has torsional strain as well as van der Waals strain. So these are the energy profile diagram. So this is the chair form, most stable. It is free from angle strain, free from torsional strain, free from van der Waals strain. This is the boat form. It does not have angle strain, but it has torsional strain as well as van der Waals strain due to flagpole hydrogen. And if we twist the boat, then the van der Waals strain gets somehow relieved and we get a twist boat. And there is a high energy, the half chair form, because it is energetically unfavorable. So it is the half chair form. So this is the picture. These are the different conformers of cyclohexane. This is the chair form. This is the chair. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 carbon atoms in the ring. And she is sitting comfortably. So it's the chair form. It is the boat form. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is the boat form. And this is the half chair. This is the half chair. You see, this is the half chair. This part is going flat. Okay, so it is highly unstable. And this is the twist boat. It is the twist boat. So this is the energy profile diagram. So the chair form is the most stable, and the most unstable is the half boat, half chair. And the boat form is unstable because of torsional strain as well as van der Waals strain, etc. Now, in the chair form of cyclohexane, there are two types of hydrogen. These red hydrogens, they are referred as axial hydrogen. And the green hydrogen, they are referred as equatorial hydrogen. So each carbon atom, it has two hydrogen atoms. And one hydrogen is called the axial hydrogen, and the other hydrogen is referred as the equatorial hydrogen. So if we consider distributed molecular axis, you will see that in each carbon atom, one CH bond, a particular CH bond, is parallel to the molecular axis. And the CH bond which is parallel to the molecular axis, it is called the axial bond. And the hydrogen so present is called the axial hydrogen. And the other hydrogen, which is not parallel to the molecular axis, it is called the equatorial hydrogen, and the corresponding CH bond is called the equatorial bond. So in the chair form of cyclohexane, there are two types of CH bond, and each CH bond contains one axial bond and one equatorial bond. The axial bond is parallel to the molecular axis, and the equatorial bond is not parallel to the molecular axis. So these are two distinctly different kinds of CH bond in cyclohexane. Six of the bonds, one on each carbon, are directed up and down, parallel to the axis of the ring. These are axial bond. The other six bonds point out of the ring. These are called equatorial bond. So these equatorial bond, they are projected outwards from the ring. And these axial bond, they are parallel to the axis of rotation of the chair conformation. So here it is clear. So these black carbon atoms, they are black balls, they are carbon atoms. And each carbon atom has two hydrogen. One hydrogen is projected directly upward or directly downward, and they are called the axial hydrogen. And the corresponding bond is called axial hydrogen, axial bond. And the remaining CH bond, they are called the equatorial bond. So these are axial bond, and these are the equatorial bonds. So axial bond, north and south. So it directs either to the north pole or it directs either to the south pole. And the equatorial bond, they lie along the equator. So if you imagine the Earth, north pole, south pole, and the equator, it's like this, running like this. Now what happens during a ring flip? So here you just imagine this one. This is the chair conformation of cyclohexane. This is carbon atom number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And in this conformer, this is chair 1. The blue colored hydrogen atoms are axial hydrogen, and the black colored hydrogen are equatorial hydrogen. Now, if we flip the ring, how we can flip the ring? You pull this nose upward and you pull this nose downward. So when you pull this nose upward, this carbon atom number 1 becomes this one. You are pulling it upward. And this carbon atom number 4, you are pulling it downward. It will come here, somewhere here. Then what you find? The axial bonds in 1 is now equatorial bond in 2. So by ring flipping, you can convert the axial bond to equatorial bond. And again, if you flip it, this is 1. If you pull it down, and if you pull this carbon atom 4 upward, you will get this conformation. And in doing so, this was the equatorial bond, it turned to be the axial bond. So by ring flipping, what you can do, you can convert the axial bond to equatorial bond. So in room temperature, there is always a ring flipping because the energy required is very, very less and it is available from room temperature. So the axial and equatorial bond get repeatedly interchanged. Okay. Now here what you see, this is a substituted cyclohexane. So here, this substituted cyclohexane, methyl cyclohexane, there may be two conformer. In one conformer, the methyl cyclohexane, methyl group is in the axial position, and in the other one, methyl group is in the equatorial position. And here you see that the axial isomer only 5% and the equatorial isomer is 95%. What does it mean? It means that when the methyl group is in the equatorial position, it is more stable. Then the methyl group is in the axial position. It is because of 1-3 diaxial repulsion, because this axial bond will repel this axial bond, 1, 2, 3. So this axial bond is projected upward, and this axial bond will be also projected upward. So there will be a 1-3 diaxial repulsion. So that 1-3 equatorial repulsion is not present. Only 1-3 diaxial repulsion is present. So the group always prefer to stay in the equatorial position rather than in the axial position. Because when the group is in the axial position, it will suffer from 1-3 diaxial repulsion, and 1-3 diaxial repulsion will lower the stability. Now what happens if the group size of the group increases? So this is fluorine, and fluorine is much smaller than methyl group. So here 40% fluorine is in the axial position, and 40%, 60% fluorine is in the equatorial position. So when the size of the atom or group decreases, then the 1-3 diaxial repulsion will also decrease, because 1-3 diaxial repulsion is simple van der Waals repulsion. And van der Waals repulsion depends upon the size. So methyl group is bulkier than fluorine atom. So methyl group, it repels more strongly than fluorine group. So when the methyl group is in the axial position, the 1-3 diaxial repulsion will be higher, and as a result, less number of molecules with methyl group in the axial position will be present. So the axial isomer for methyl group was only 5%, but for the axial isomer for fluorocyclohexane, it is 40%, because fluorine is smaller than methyl group. So 1-3 diaxial repulsion will be less. Then what about tertiary methyl group? So this is tertiary methyl group. You see, it is highly crowded. Tertiary methyl group is a bulky group. So 1-3 diaxial repulsion will be very, very strong with a bulky tertiary methyl group. And as a result, only 0.01% is of the axial isomer, and 99.99% is of the equatorial isomer. So what we have learned? What we have learned that in the chair conformation of cyclohexane, there is a 1-3 diaxial repulsion, which is basically a van der Waals repulsion. And van der Waals repulsion depends upon the bulkiness of the group. And the group always prefer to stand in the equatorial position rather than in the axial position. And as the size of the group increases, like a tertiary butyl group, the percentage of axial isomer decreases, and the percentage of equatorial isomer increases. So this is methyl cyclohexane. What I was talking about, it is in the axial position. You are flipping the ring. It is a boat form. And through boat form, it is in the, again, chair form. So the interconversion from chair to chair form, that is a ring flipping, it takes place through boat form. So these are the different conformers of methyl cyclohexane in Newman projection formula. So friends, I hope I could explain you conformation of cyclohexane. So unlike alkane, cycloalkanes have another type of strain that is called the angle strain. And this angle strain can be used to explain the destability of cycloalkanes, but not with cyclohexane. Because in cyclohexane, there is no angle strain. And the Mohr's idea regarding the planar geometry of cycloalkane is not accepted. So friends, if you like this video, please subscribe my channel. Myself, Vedanta Kumar Bora, Associate Professor, Department of Chemical Science, DR College, Gulaghat, Assam, India. So again, with a promise that I will be back soon with new video lecture. Till then, goodbye. Thank you.